Hi, this is Dr. Ankur Gupta, and once again welcome to another session of regularcrisis.com. And today we are going to discuss a very important aspect of ventilator care bundle, which is how to do a proper endotracheal tube suction. As a bonus, we will also discuss how far you should insert the suction catheter while doing the endotracheal tube suction. So first we'll see this, and second we'll see this. Let's begin. Okay, so today we will understand how much length of suction catheter should be put inside the endotracheal tube while you are doing suction on a patient who is on ventilator. So let's understand. So this is your suction catheter. Let's see how much is the length of this catheter. It is written on the back. Its total length is 53 cm and effective length is 50 cm. Okay. So total length means from this end to the complete end, which is 53 cm, and up to this mark, which the part which can go inside the endotracheal tube is 50 cm. So effective length of this suction catheter is 50 cm. Now let's see what is the length of the endotracheal tube from this end to this end. You can see here it has written 28, 30, then 32 and 34. So approximately length of this endotracheal tube, which is the size is 8, is around 34 cm. And you always know that this tip, which is inside the patient, remains approximately 5 cm above the carina. So if we add those 5 cm plus this 35 cm approximately, which gives you a length of 40 cm. And the length of this suction catheter is 50 cm. So we should always leave some 8 to 10 cm of the suction catheter above this end of endotracheal tube. If you push this whole suction catheter inside, it will cause damage to the carina, will cause mucosal ulceration, and will form the blood clots in the trachea of the patient. Now, here I have this 6.5 number endotracheal tube, and the length differs. Here it is 26, 28, 30. So approximately 30 cm. In this case, 30 plus 5 cm of the carina, the effective length will be 35 cm. So in a smaller tube, you should go somewhere around up to 35, 36 cm. So you will leave a little more portion of the catheter outside. Fortunately, we have one suction catheter here, which is labeled also. You can see here it is labeled 5, 15, 20, 30, 35, 40. So up to this mark, you should put the catheter inside and you should leave this portion of the catheter outside the endotracheal tube. Similar thing you should consider while doing a suction in the tracheostomy tube. The effective length of this tracheostomy tube is somewhere around 10 to 12 cm. Add 5 cm up to the carina, so approximately 15 to 20 cm. So only approximately 20 cm. Means 15 to 20 cm should go inside the patient via the tracheostomy tube. Otherwise, it will cause damage to the carina and the trachea. On tracheostomy, you should consider this. Otherwise, if you push this much inside 40 cm, it will definitely going to damage the trachea. So, I hope now you will understand why we don't want the full suction catheter to be inserted in the endotracheal tube. Always leave approximately 8 to 10 cm of the suction catheter outside end of the endotracheal tube. And in tracheostomy, this length decreases to somewhere around 15 to 20 cm. And now we'll go to the patient bedside and we'll demonstrate you how to do a proper endotracheal tube suction. Okay, so now we will demonstrate you how to do a proper endotracheal tube suction. With me is my full nursing team. You can see from here, Sister Madhu, Athar, Mahesh, Sister Niyomi, and Brother Rajesh. Sister Niyomi and Brother Rajesh will demonstrate you how to do the proper endotracheal tube suction. Before starting the procedure, you should understand few points which are very important. This is your endotracheal tube and this is your cath mount. For doing endotracheal tube suction via open technique, you have to disconnect this tube from the cath mount like this. Or you can go through this hole, which is tubing. Now, whenever you disconnect this cath mount or open this tube, the ventilation to the patient is being stopped. So, this can cause hypoxia, this can cause tachycardia, this can cause bready. So, the maximum duration for which this should be disconnected is 10 seconds. Now, you should also look the saturation of the patient. If it is less than 90, then the duration should be further reduced
5-6 seconds and you should be quick enough to go inside and come out. Also, while doing the endotracheal tube suction, always increase the FiO2 of the patient to 100% so that you get the maximum time for doing the suction. We need two people to do the suction. The person who will be doing the suction should always wear the sterile gloves, and the person who is assisting the suction either can wear the sterile gloves or the simple examination gloves will suffice. Now we'll start the procedure. First, she will give the catheter to the person who will do. You should open this much, then to the sterile hand, connect to the suction catheter, and this is the way to take out the suction catheter. You just see, this is a thumb control suction catheter. By using the thumb, you can control the pressure in the suction catheter, which helps you control the pressure and reduce the trauma. One more thing, while doing the suction, we will not go full inside the endotracheal tube, which we have explained you previously in the video. When we will go inside, we'll keep this thumb pressure open so that no pressure is being exerted while going inside. We will only close the thumb while coming out with a rotatory movement. So please disconnect. We'll going inside. We are not enough. Now close the thumb and with a rotatory movement you should come out. Okay. Now give some time, at least 30-40 seconds for the patient to get ventilated again, and meanwhile you should clean this catheter by putting this in a normal saline bottle, sister. So now we have cleaned the catheter and we are again ready for a next cycle of suction. So now they will do it very fast, yes, to demonstrate you. We disconnected, we are going inside, we are not exerting pressure, stop here. We'll come out with a rotatory movement and we'll connect again. Okay. So this is the proper way of doing the endotracheal tube suction. I thank my nursing team for helping me in making this video. I hope those my fellow nursing staff are seeing, or those doctors are seeing, this will help in the patient care at the bedside. Thank you.